hand out of your pants.
At least put your tray table up. Put the crack pipe down.
You're the least without sin person I know.
Aral, we are on the air right now.
Oh, I was digging for gold.
Wow. That's what's eating Gilbert Grape, my friends.
Well, listen, call me casual, but I love to take my time.
I don't know where your head ends and this weird turtleneck sweater begins.
Speaking of which, whatever happened to that porn star you were doing?
Oh my God, it's huge.
And now,
it's West
by me and West.
It's Monday, October 28th, 2013. This is a special Halloween edition of West by Midwest. It's episode 38.
Halloween!
Woo! My name's Chuck. I'm broadcasting live from Los Angeles, California.
My name's Aral Gribble. I'm broadcasting live from Lansing, Michigan. And we have our producer, Rob Hubbard, broadcasting live from...
Chelsea, Michigan.
Chelsea, Michigan.
Chelsea, Michigan.
Where is she? We hang out on Google+Hangouts and record live every Monday night, usually, or at least the last two Monday nights. And if you go on the Facebook page Monday night, when we go live, we will post that link and you can hang out with us. And this week it's great because you can see the crazy costumes that we're wearing.
Yeah, super crazy. I mean, I can't wear mine the entire show because you won't be able to hear me through my horse mask. But,
horse face? Why the long face?
Why the long face? Yeah, so I'll put it on periodically throughout the show. But Aral, you're an old man, or who? Your grandma?
Grandma Aral.
Grandma. Aral.
Grandma Gribble.
Quite a beard you got there, Grandma. Grandma
better
Gribble.
To hear you with. I don't know.
And then we have our producer Rob. You're dressed as the Dark Knight, right?
I'm Batman.
I am Lowell Batman.
I'm Batman.
But you're not right, you're not like Christian Bale, you're Adam West Batman. You've got the
Adam
old school.
West Batman, yeah. we were talking because our son Wesley, he's not even 2 years old yet. He's Robin.
He's Robin. And
we were talking about if I'm Batman, he's Robin, what's Katie gonna be? I thought maybe I should be like young Adam West Batman, and then since she's pregnant, she could be old fat Adam West Batman.
Oh, that's good. It's nice. Stuff.
I thought that was clever too. She opted
she didn't
to
like
be
it.
Pregnant Batgirl.
I like pregnant Batgirl. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Yes. Batman, Batgirl get a little crazy. Folks, remember you can check us out on iTunes, and hopefully you are also listening to this on iTunes, so you know that. But, so check us out. If you're hanging out with us live, remember all of our old podcasts are on iTunes, edited, and they're not as fun to watch, but they're a lot more fun to listen to. And this podcast is brought to you by Ed Grabo, an invisible man sleeping in your bed. Who are you going to call? Ed Grabo.
Ed Grabo.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Da-da-da-da-da-da. Bustin' makes me feel good. Friends, you're going to want to stick around for the second half of the show where we have this week's special Halloween guest.
Yeah, who I'm super excited about.
Yeah, paranormal investigator Colleen May is on the show.
Real-life paranormal investigator.
So excited to talk to her. So
stick around, folks. We're going to get the inside scoop on real live ghosts. Before we do, how was everybody's week? It's happy Halloween, man.
Yeah, happy Halloween. This is Halloween week. Real excited. I ran the Rock and Roll Los Angeles Halloween half marathon yesterday. So
costume?
Back to back half marathons. Yeah. I was actually wearing. I went as business horse. I was wearing the
the horse mask.
Horse mask, and then I had like a dress shirt and tie and. I was carrying like a travel mug, so it just looked like I was like running to the office. I ran the costume. It was funny to see a bunch of costumes out there. It was a good time and a good half marathon.
God, it sounds awful. I remember just like how hard it was to go to Halloween parties with costumes. Like I remember when I went as Shrek one year.
Oh my God,
the Shrek. Makeup was like sweating off,
melting off me.
Like the,
I'm sorry about your couch and all this green makeup on it.
Like I started like taking off layers of clothes. So by the end of it, I just looked like some green homeless man.
Yeah, I don't know how some of these people run in these costumes. I mean, it was like, I they gave us a list of where all the professional photographers for the event were located. So I made a list of that, and
you're so vain.
Whenever I was approaching the photographers, I put the mask on, but for the rest of the race, I wasn't. I only wore it for the last mile of the.
God, I can't even imagine. Yeah.
It was pretty crazy. Awesome. Must have been embarrassing for anyone that was passed by Business Horse, my friends. Damn. Killing it out there.
Good stuff. What else? So this weekend, Halloween, I don't really have anything going on. I mean, I did the show over the weekend. I feel like I'm getting old. Like, I don't go to any parties anymore. Did you?
Oh, man. My friend, one of the kids, actually one of the guys in Bad Porn, he lives in this like 8-bedroom house in Hollywood, and every year they throw this gigantic Halloween bash, and it's like seriously just like any of those like Halloween parties you see in the movies. You know, it's like Wade or She's All That. It's like this huge, just epic party. There's kegs, there's thousands of
this
people.
This is what you went to?
I mean, I went to it last year, and it was insanity. This year, it was this past Saturday, and had plans to go and everything. It didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. Before the party, I was at work. I had to work till 10. I was at the restaurant. I stopped into the dispensary for just a moment to like get some cones so I could make some joints for the party. And they had these samples of medicated tea that they were giving out on Saturday night, and
with medical marijuana tea.
Yeah, enhanced.
Just to clarify,
tea.
Enhanced.
So enhanced tea. They had a chai tea and a green tea, and so they were like, "Hey, Chuck, you got to try this." And I was like, "You guys, I'm not gonna get really messed up off of this because I have so much shit to do." And they were like, "No, you'll be fine." I ended up drinking a couple of samples of it, and you know, like maybe an hour later at work, I was totally messed up, and I was like, oh man, like I'm totally stoned. Got through my shift and was preparing to go to the party, and by the time my friends got to pick me up got to my apartment to pick me up, I was feeling better. I was like, okay,
it's been a few hours.
I've got the half marathon in the morning, but I'm gonna still just bust it out because I had hyped up the party all week and I had gotten a bunch of people to go. We had to run to FedEx office to finish the costume. We had to print something up for our costumes, but we stopped back at my place, and I was like kind of feeling queasy because the way my friend Dave was driving around. He was
Dave
trying
Craze.
To haul. Dave Craze. He was hauling
drives
ass.
Drives so crazy.
crazily through the streets, weaving up and down, and I was just not feeling well. And I told them, I was like, guys, I'm not feeling so well, but I'm going to run up to the apartment, grab this stuff. As soon as I jumped out of the car, I puked all over the sidewalk. It was just like, I think it was a combination of
crazy driving,
and then
the tea,
the funny tea, and I just ralphed all over. And so I ended up not being able to go to the party. Everyone had a blast. There were so many people. All these pictures of them on Facebook.
You're getting old, man. You're too old to be partying like that, man.
I mean, I did. It was a good thing. I went home and I slept it off and I was prepared for the half marathon. But no, I missed this epic
what's happened to us? Like, I sit around, like, this grandma wig is for real. Like, I don't do,
you've colored your hair in a while.
Right, I am doing I'm doing the show this weekend and stuff for Halloween, but, like, yeah, we can't party the epic way we used to, my friend. You're going to end up puking in the street, and I'm going to end up falling asleep by midnight, so.
Right, we don't bounce back like we used to.
We don't bounce back. Speaking of marijuana, though, my mother from last week, she listened to the episode because my brother-in-law was on it. Yeah, she felt the need, even though she's not a fan. She said, we've done well to clean it up a little, which I completely disagree with. But
I don't know what she's
she also said she loves your idea to lose weight by smoking marijuana.
Really?
So, I think my mom's going to turn into a pothead anyway. But yeah, so for my Halloween, this coming up this Thursday, I do have a performance of The Woman in Black, the scary ghost story. Yeah.
Doing a show on Halloween.
Making me work a show on Halloween. It's not like, it ain't Christmas, all
right? Right, but I mean.
You don't get it off. And yeah, it's like a Halloween show, you know. It's like
it is. It's the theme is
show that you should do on Halloween. It's the woman in black, right?
But Halloween is a night where people are with their kids, are trick or treating. They're
See, that's the thing. We're gonna hand out candy after the show.
Oh, so an incentive to go to the show.
The actors will come out into the lobby afterwards, folks, and you'll get some candy from the woman in black.
Listen, man, how are tickets for this Thursday? Halloween night.
Well, we got like six people.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, like, who's gonna go? You're either trick or treating, you're giving out candy, you're checking your children's candy for razor blades.
Right. If you're not giving out candy at that point, from 8 to 10 is when you're checking for arsenic-laced Snickers bars. And
you're looking for Molly scattered through Skittles. Tootsie Rolls.
That's an urban legend, man. That never actually happened. Like,
it didn't?
All those scares and stuff. Like,
yeah.
The only time there was a razor, well, I don't know this for sure, but I'm pretty sure, my internet sure, that the only time a razor blade was ever found was from a relative. It was like somebody they knew. It wasn't a stranger.
Oh, it wasn't just like some crazy neighbor that...
Right, just throwing in razor blades and kids' candy. It was like, I hate my nephew. I hope he chokes on a razor blade, which in some ways is almost worse. But yeah, man, that shit doesn't happen.
I'm glad that it doesn't happen that often. I mean, it's just like that would be just awful for something like that.
I'm gonna put it in your candy from now on.
Don't you dare touch my candy. did you get to see any costumes at all over the weekend? Were you?
A trick-or-treating event in downtown Williamson right before a matinee this weekend, so I did see that. I saw some kids. There were a couple Batmans, Rob Hubbard. There was, what else? Oh, gosh. I mean, that's the difference. Like, you know, little kids have their sort of staple, like, oh, I'm a ghost, I'm a pirate, whatever.
Iron Man,
you don't have, like, Heisenberg.
Right. Miley and
you don't have that rolling around children's
Sharknado. Right. Yeah, I mean that's the best thing about being in LA. We have, you know, just people go all out for Halloween, so we see like really, really awesome costumes.
Yeah,
and I didn't see that many, but I just, you know, it's like the people, I don't know if you agree with me on this, Aral, but
here we go.
Like zombies? Really? People are still doing the zombie thing? I mean, it's like...
Yeah, man.
I
feel like, what's that TV show?
The Walking Dead, yes. I know we all love zombies, but
Zombies are hot right now. They're hot.
Zombies are so hot right now.
No, zombies were hot like six, 7 years ago. Now it's just...
They're hotter now.
No, it's way overdone. And
is this one of your weird fetishes? Like, is this like the anime thing? Like, it's anime and zombie porn that you're into?
No, I'm not a big fan of zombies. I just recognize that they're hot right now.
Rob's like, you know what really gets me off is an undead woman.
Listen,
undead anime.
Whatever's undead hot to Rob anime right now is like 5 years behind. I'm telling you guys, zombies are like the situation. It's become a situation where
Rob is that like old dad. He's like, it's really cool right now. Like, really?
Right?
Slap bracelets. Right, guys?
No, I mean, seriously, I feel like it's gotten to a situation where zombies are like the lazy costume. It's like the sexy cat costume what I mean, like, girls will just throw on, you know, they'll throw their black yoga pants on, put a little triangle on their nose, and they're a sexy cat. And it's just like,
absolutely,
I feel like that's what's happened to zombies. Even if people are creative with it, even if they are like Obama zombie or like whatever, I still think that zombies are like way played out and people are still...
Obama, I agree with you, Chuck. Zombies are hot right now, but I think what you're saying is absolutely correct.
So wait, Chuck, are you saying you saw women dressed as like hot zombies?
I mean, all over. I saw, you know, like I was telling you, there was a girl that was dressed as like, you know, hot homemaker zombie. She had like, you know, a little apron on and a cute skirt. She was a zombie.
That's what bugs me, is like, why does every woman's costume have to be like sexy whatever? You know, it's like really sexy Obama, or like, you know, like, I'm a sexy giraffe.
Ninja Turtles.
Right. I'm a sexy sumo wrestler. Like, what? Come on. But what are you? So what are you gonna do? Are you gonna go out this Thursday? And what are you gonna? What you gonna do for your costume?
I didn't go trick or treating last year, but I might try to go this year because it's easier with a mask. You know, when it comes to costumes for me, and we were talking about this. I like to either wear a mask even though it's annoying sometimes, or dress as kind of like an Asian character. Like I've dressed up as Short Round, or
right. Use the mask God gave you.
Right. Hey, easy. So because I don't like to. You know, it's good for other people, and I'm not like shooting down other people's costumes. But like for me, I don't want to be like Asian Superman or like.
Sure.
You know, like that's why I don't dress up in like other things like that, because it's just like, oh, hey, check it out. There's Asian Garfunkel or whatever. You know what I mean? Like I don't want.
Right.
It's like not.
I'm still waiting for you to dress up like Short Round.
I did do that. I did that in like 2009 or 2008.
Oh.
Dressed up as
Short
Round.
Where was I?
Well, I know. We were supposed to be old Indiana Jones and old Short Round.
Oh, right.
Maybe we'll do it one year. But, yeah, so this year I have the horse mask because I don't have anything. We were, for Saturday night, we had Guess Who costume. You remember that board game Guess Who?
Oh, Guess Who.
We were going to do that. Dave and Carrie ended up still doing that. But, yeah, I don't really have an idea besides the horse costume.
You're talking about laziness, right? Like the lazy zombie costumes. Like I got some real lazy costume ideas for you, okay?
Like what? Like what?
I found this on Mashable. You can go as a spice rack. Just wear a bra and put a bunch of spices in it.
So these are punny. These
absolutely.
Are punny costume ideas.
You can put some black eye makeup on and a P on your T-shirt, the letter P, or a couple letter P's. Go as
that?
The Black Eyed Peas.
Oh my god!
take like staple a bunch of little cereal boxes onto your clothes, stab them with some forks.
Yeah, serial killer. Heard of that? We've seen that.
Put a T-shirt on that just says "Go Ceiling, Go." You're a ceiling fan.
Oh man, come on. I saw a really, really good punny costume online, and it was this girl that was dressed as Stevie Wonder Woman, and so she had a Wonder Woman costume on, but then like her head she had the like dreads and the like 70s Stevie Wonder had like sunglasses on. Like
I don't know if that's
the line. I think that's true.
That's cool, but I don't know if that's like punny. That's more like mashup costume.
Mashup? Yeah. Oh,
that's
yeah,
a
you're
mashup.
Right.
Yeah. My favorite pun, though, and you can't pull this off. I couldn't pull it off. You have to be a redheaded kid. But if you're redhead, you know, with the freckles and everything, just throw a bunch of loaves around your, like a loaves of bread around your neck. You're a gingerbread man.
Oh, Jesus. All right. If you listeners don't have ideas yet for Halloween, you just got a bunch. You should try those. Wonderful costume.
But you got to be careful, like, playing into the whole, like, skin tone or Asian thing. I mean,
that was my first actual idea for this year was to dress up as, and Aral, we talked about this, as Crazy Eyes from the Netflix original series.
That's right, and I was like, you can't do that.
Orange is the New Black. But yeah, right. I'm not black. Crazy Eyes is black.
I mean, you are ethnic, at least, so it wouldn't be as bad, but still.
Yeah, she's
it's
a
dangerous.
Black character. Right, it's a black character on the show that's dressed with
Orange
cornrows.
Orange is the New Black, yeah.
Orange is the New Black.
Everybody knows Crazy Eyes. If you don't know Crazy Eyes, watch the show. Crazy Eyes is fantastic. She's the best character on the show.
Funniest character on the show. And we talked about me doing it, but yeah, you gave me the good advice of not doing it. Julianne Hough,
being racist.
Wore a blackface Halloween costume, Crazy Eyes, and then had to apologize on Twitter afterwards. Yeah, 25 years.
I did see that.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Oh man.
Julianne Hough, actress, 25-year-old actress, triggered controversy after she showed up at the Beverly Hills Bash as Crazy Eyes, a character played by Uzo Aduba in the hit Netflix drama Orange Is the New Black.
That's right.
Hough covered her face in dark makeup, styled her hair like the characters, nodded. Do and wore an orange jumpsuit and prison ID splashed with the words Crazy Eyes. So, yeah, she went blackface.
Wait, she tweeted something about it? What did she say?
She had to apologize about it, and she said...
Oh, she wasn't like, what's up, I'm Crazy Eyes.
Blackface
is the new black.
Oh, man. No, she had to apologize publicly. She wrote,
of course.
It certainly was never my intention to be disrespectful or demeaning to anyone in any way. I realized that my costume hurt... Yeah, exactly, and offended people, and I truly apologize. Where was your... PR person on that one. I mean, wasn't there like at least 20 people that were like,
halfway through the makeup, they're like, oh, you're not doing what I think you're doing, right? Because this isn't 1910.
Exactly. Yes,
Juliana Hough, what does she do? Isn't she like
she was on Dancing with the Stars, I believe.
And then
now she's going.
Yeah.
She's moving into like acting, but yeah, like what the other thing was is that she went with a group of her friends, that they were all playing characters from the show. And why wasn't she like? Why didn't she play the main character?
She would have been perfect as the main character.
Right, exactly.
She's blonde. Yeah. No, you know what it is, and this is there was like a Facebook debate that happened recently about it that I saw, where people were like, no, straight up, she did this as a publicity stunt because people were like, Juliana who? And so this is a way of like, hey, remember me? I'm going to do something offensive and apologize for it right away. And
the Hollywood machine gets you every time. I can't even believe this. It's all just a PR. Jesus.
So, folks, for this Halloween episode, we're going to leave the Hollywood machine behind a little. as you know, if you're an avid listener of the show, we share news stories. But that was sort of the only news story we're going to share this week. We're going to get real with some fucking Halloween ghost story.
Spooky up in here.
So, Rob, at some point, imagine, if you will, Rob playing some spooky ghost music here. He won't do it right now because he's not prepared at all. And because he didn't know this was going to happen. And then we go into the West by Midwest ghost story.
Ghost stories.
All right, so the first one is called The House in Ypsy, and it's a ghost story that Chuck and I actually, it's our story together, because we lived in this house. It was the house that we lived in on
311 Washtenaw.
311 Washtenaw. Yeah. And the funniest, and so this is a funny ghost story, because the problem is apparently it's haunted, but we only know it's haunted because our neighbors downstairs. This was a house, an old spooky house that was turned into two apartments. We lived upstairs. They lived downstairs. The basement is creepy as shit, and they had the basement. And yeah, I mean, it looked like somebody was hung and just gutted. Yeah.
Right. Silence of the Lambs basement.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Totally Silence of the Lambs basement. But we never had anything, you know, whatever. But our neighbors swore that it was haunted.
That they were haunted. Yeah.
I mean, we did. This was after you moved out, Chuck. And it may have been just all the drugs that James Fraunfelter and I were doing. But my old roommate, my new roommate and I could swear that we would hear footsteps going up the stairs to the apartment. And never back down again.
That was the crackhead walking up the stairs.
Walking and then just jumping out the window.
Crawling out the window.
Like, hey, man, I get some drugs.
Ain't nobody home. Oh, I'm out of here.
I'm out of here. Out the window. Popo on my ass. No, so that was the creepiest thing to us. But our neighbors downstairs,
they
get bananas.
Yeah, they claimed the paranormal activity was happening at their
right. They claimed that heavy things would fall off of their pantry shelves, like big heavy cans and stuff. And I mean, nobody would be around. I just thought that was because the floor was fucking crooked and shit. I mean, these were
And our super didn't do shit around the place.
No, it was a shitty fucking slum, Ypsy slum that we lived in. I was like, of course shit falls. Like, close your fucking doors and put a little latch on, dude.
Everything's going to fall.
Everything's going to fall around. And then there was the moment with the girl, our neighbor's boyfriend, who was there all the time. The, like, super pothead who's there all the time.
Right, playing Xbox. He didn't have anything else
to do. Right, didn't have shit to do. He was always there. And he'd always want to hang out with us, and we'd be like, man, I don't know, dude. I got to get up early. I'm out.
I got a thing.
And he thought we were best friends. You remember what he did one time?
Well, which, oh yeah, when we were both at work.
Yeah, so you're at the restaurant, I'm in Ann Arbor working on a show or something, and we both get calls individually from this asshole, like frantic calls, begging us to come home in the middle of the day.
Yeah.
Guys, come home. And he's sitting outside on the porch.
Yeah, he wasn't even in the apartment. He
couldn't
was just like
go
so
back
spooked.
Inside
yeah.
the apartment because he swore he heard a ghost. I was like, motherfucker, you high. You were just high. And I was ready to write the whole thing off. But then, and Chuck, you didn't know this. I told you this earlier today. His girlfriend, our roommate,
the downstairs neighbor, not our roommate.
Our downstairs neighbor, a housemate, if you will. Christina? I can't remember her name.
Here's a stupid thing about this story is that we don't know the names of our former neighbors.
No,
we can't remember what they are.
At the time.
We don't know what her name is.
She was John or Leo, Ralph, I don't know.
Leonardo. She was Hispanic of Hispanic descent.
Christina?
With Conchita
Rivera?
Conchita Rivera?
Charo? Rock me a Hispanic name.
Consuela?
Consuela. There we go. That was it.
What happened with
Consuela? So we're racist assholes. But so Christina was... They had this tiny little bathroom, right? Remember this bathroom? Like, We had a huge bathroom.
Right.
Yeah, I used to vomit all over it.
You could fit like 15 people in our bathroom.
Right. We had just a party in the bathroom. But theirs was tiny, and like tiny. I'd use their toilet and be worried I was going to get stuck between the sink and the wall. Like, so she's in this bathroom, and there's no room for anybody to be behind her. She's brushing her hair.
Right.
And she heard from behind her, Christina.
What?
Yeah, she heard somebody like whisper her name, and she freaked out. Her boyfriend, Bubba, whatever the fuck his name is, is in the living room playing Xbox, and she's like, "Hey, what?" And he was like, "Whoa, what are you talking about?" And she was like, "Oh my god, he's not anywhere near me. That was the fucking ghost." And she like ran out of the bathroom, and
man, I just love how we didn't. Either we were too stoned to realize shit
was
happening.
Yeah, I was drunk the whole time. Like, ghosts could have been like rattling chains on my neck, and they'd be like, "Wake up, you fucking asshole! Like, leave me alone, dude. Leave me alone."
Right. Yeah, like soup cans could have been flying in front of us, and we wouldn't even have noticed like what was going on. But our neighbors downstairs were having serious poltergeist.
Paranormal activity. That's awesome. Well, Ypsilanti, Michigan, is renowned for its paranormal activity.
Yeah, it's haunted, isn't it?
Yeah, there was a serial killer in the 60s who's still in prison. He's due out for parole soon, actually.
Whoa.
I think. But yeah, a bunch of murders, college students, on Riverside Drive or whatever it was. And so a lot of like those houses are creepy and haunted. I remember with the same Shrek Halloween party that one of the guys tried to like give us a tour of the
farmhouse
where all the murders happened.
Right, and we went around the side of the house, and there was like this little like they didn't even know about this little like cellar part of the house.
We were like, "Let's go down in," and he was like, "No, dude, you guys have to take this seriously." And we were like cracking jokes and got all mad. God, we're the worst. So, Ypsilanti, folks, check it out. It's scary as shit.
Yeah, if you're not scared by ghosts and whatnot, you'll be scared by the crackheads.
So here's another ghost story it's actually from my girlfriend, Lynn. She went to school in Bowling Green, Ohio. Bowling Green University. And they had the old Eva Marie Saint Theater. Eva Marie Saint, the old film screen actress.
Okay.
Academy Award winner, right? So this theater, this building, it's one of the oldest buildings on campus. It's over 100 years old. And it was like, you know, a lot of theaters are quote-unquote haunted. You know, you have like a ghost light where it's like you constantly keep a light on the stage.
Right, yes.
It's, you know, the tale, right, the myth is that you're leaving the light on so the ghosts have light to perform by and blah, blah, blah. Really, it's so you don't bust your ass when you come in the next morning.
Yeah, so you don't fall on your face.
Right. But so a lot of theaters have, you know, like, rumors about being haunted, but Lynn was like, no, this one for straight is, like, haunted. It has two ghosts. They know the names. There's a whole mythology around it. Oh, so there's God. Alice and the Man in Tan.
The Man in Tan?
The Man in Tan. We'll start with the Man in Tan. He was an old... what's the guy that cleans shit? Jesus.
The janitor.
Janitor. He was an old janitor. Oh, Rob Hover. I think we're going to go long here. Anyway.
Keep going.
So he was this old janitor, and he would only appear in the costume room in the basement.
Okay.
And he only attacked men because he used to, when he was alive, he would walk young women home to keep them safe.
The janitor right? would?
Yeah, which I'm like, that's creepy.
Well, that's creepy right there. Like who's letting right. the weird janitor? Okay, anyway, keep going.
Hey, are you... Hold on. Time out. Are you ghosted?
No.
Oh, nope. We're good. God damn it. Okay, so there's the creepy janitor guy, right? Uh-huh. And so he resides in this costume room and would only, like, attack or do shitty things to the men. So the women were always like, oh, yeah, and they would, like... he would be seen every once in a while, and they were like, no, he's nice. And then... But, like, one time, this... this guy that Lynn was doing a show with, he went downstairs to pull some costumes or whatever. Door closed. He was locked inside.
Whoa. The door closed behind him and he was
So that's the Man in Tan, right? And like I guess there's a lot of other creepy stories about him or whatever. But Alice was like the main ghost. She was a girl, she was a student from Bowling Green.
See, I hate the beginning of this already. It's already like somebody that was there.
No, I know, right?
I
didn't think this just listen cuz it's for real, right? Cuz I think it's bullshit whatever, right? But her name was Alice, and the rumor is she was an old student. Nobody really knows, but the rumor is she was an old student, committed suicide and forever trapped in the Eva Marie Saint Theater.
Ah.
So there were all these rituals that they still did, and I think it's closed down now, like they tore the building down finally, but when Lynn was there and they were performing there, they would still do this. Every performance, for every opening, the stage manager would have to show up early and ask Alice, may we open the show? You couldn't talk about Alice in the building. And people were, like, serious about it, she said. Like, you know, if you were the newbie or whatever, and you're like, what's with the ghost around this place? People were like, no, shh, I'll tell you outside. And, yeah, like, they'd take him outside.
We can't talk about it.
Right, because when you talked about Alice inside the theater, shit would go wrong. Like, people would get hurt. More often, though, like, just, like, super important and like, rare props that you needed for the show would go missing during a run.
Gone. Yeah.
Right. So you're like, I need this gun for this next scene. Where the fuck is it? It's gone. Show's ruined.
So Alice would like drop lights on people and just like if you talked
about
it.
All she did was steal. She's just like kind of annoying. She stole props, whatever. Here's the creepiest thing though, right? For every single performance, they would leave a seat open in the balcony.
No.
Right? For Alice to watch the show. Opening night, they would place a rose on the seat.
Are you serious? They do this for every show?
Every show. Well, just opening gets the rose. Every other show, they would make sure they didn't sell that seat. Because if you sold the seat, you should get pissed off. And people reported, and Lynn said she actually saw this happen once, where, you know, the seat is up at the top of the show.
Don't even, man!
At the end of the show,
down.
The seat is down.
Come on, dude. There's no way, Alice,
dude. Okay, so this next one. So this next one gets even spookier. Okay, this happened to me when I was really little.
Oh, this is okay? A personal one.
It's personal. It's called the Shadow Man. All right. Now, when I was little, I was a runt. I was a bit of a runt as a child.
No, but you weren't.
I was not always a giant fat man. Okay, but but I was also always like every kid is. I was afraid of the dark.
Yeah. Yes.
Right. So I remember I was afraid of the dark, I couldn't sleep, and my bedroom was at the far end of the hallway leading from the living room. And right at the end of the living room, or right at the end of the hallway, right into the living room was this sofa, this recliner that one of my parents would inevitably sit in and watch TV. So a lot of times I could just sort of like get up and look down the hall and see my mom sitting there or my dad, right? And I could hear the TV and whatever, but I couldn't sleep, and I, you know, and like the shadows, whatever, were playing my tricks on my mind or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And I swear I saw like the silhouette of a shadow man, like a man, but a black silhouette of a man wearing like some, almost like a cowboy hat or like a fedora.
Oh,
like,
God.
Just move across the wall. But, I mean, it's like black on black, right? Because it's dark in my bedroom. It's the middle of the
black
night.
Black on black on black.
Right. So I'm like, fuck. And I saw that. I freaked out. I jumped up. I flipped the light onto my bedroom, ran down the hall, and I was like, Mom, I can't sleep. I'm scared. You know, can I please just hang out with you for a while? And she was like, no, it's fine. It's just the dark. There's nothing to be afraid of. I turned back to look down the hall. I saw this silhouetted black hand just come around the door and flick the lights off.
What the fuck? No, you didn't.
I fucking did.
Oh, my God,
I
man.
Did.
That is freaky.
It took me a while to sleep in that bedroom. Needless to say, I slept in my parents' bed for quite some time after that.
18 years.
For 29 years.
Dude, that's crazy, man.
Right?
That's scary. I don't know. I guess I'm just like stupid to it, but like I don't really have any ghost stories. I haven't really experienced any kind of paranormal activity, but man, it would freak me the hell out. Like I would seriously, if I saw a ghost or something, I would seriously probably just start running and not stop until I don't
right?
know, I like passed out
this
or something
why,
because I'd be so scared.
This is why Chuck does Roga, so he can prepare for when he has to run from a ghost.
That's why I'm always wearing these tennis shoes, because if a ghost pops up, boom, I'm gone, man. Jesus, dude, I would be freaked out.
Awesome. So as an internet show, right?
We should
talk about like internet ghost stories.
Yeah, I mean, well, the way that ghost stories now spread around, you know, to be just like you'd talk around the campfire and like things would change about the story or whatever. But nowadays, you can go to, you know, certain websites. There was one called 4chan in particular that has
4chan, And 4chan kind of actually was sort of the birth of the anonymous movement and... you know, it's this underground, but it's also
community.
Like this,
yeah,
it's a big forum, but it's also like it's for. There's a lot of anime porn, Rob. You should check it out. You'll love it. But they have a paranormal page.
X, yeah,
4chan X, and people share creepy ghost stories called Creepypasta.
Creepypasta.
That's sort of the new internet way of telling ghost stories. And so, because we're an internet show, I thought we would share some creepypasta.
Yeah, these ones are serious, you guys. Like, if you go onto this website, you will freak the hell out. Like, I was scared myself just reading some of these, just the synopsis for some of them. But
right.
We're gonna talk about one that's kind of shorter on there. Aral, did you wanna? What was?
Yeah. So if you know, there's lots of really fun ones like the Slender Man and Robert the Doll. The Russian Sleep Experiment, Jeff the Killer.
Yeah.
If you look at all those up, I mean, they're on – at this point, you can find them on lots and lots of websites, right? So if you just sort of Google those. I read one that's kind of fun called Psychosis. There's a really lame one called Doors. I don't tell. But because it's short, I wanted to read to you. It's called Anora Petrova.
Anora Petrova.
Creepypasta. And the fun thing about Creepypasta is because it's online, it's using a lot of really fun things. Sometimes it'll be episodic, and it's almost like you're going online constantly checking to see, oh my God, if they post it again. And it's
right.
like it right under the guise of like, this is my live journal. I'm posting this shit as it's happening. Or
there's multimedia ones. There's ones with like video or that have
right
video
one game one
ties.
Really fun one that was like the Legend of Zelda,
yeah,
and it was like they used actual clips from Legend of Zelda and like edited them to make them all twisted and what and warped and shit. It was great, but this one is written as an email,
okay,
an email.
Yeah. All right.
So it says, Bree, don't delete this. I know you hate me, but we were best friends once, and I need you to read this. I think I'm in serious trouble, and there's nothing you can do. Oh, you also have to imagine that I'm a woman. All right.
That's your Grandma Gribble.
That I'm Grandma Gribble. But I need you to read this so you understand. I know even talks in sectionals. It's been forever, but what happened to you wasn't my fault. At least it wasn't entirely my fault. I know everyone thinks it was, but I would never do anything to hurt you. This is going to sound crazy, but I need to tell you this so that someone knows. It started when we were in the eighth grade. It was the night before the Crystal Classic competition. I was at home, and I couldn't sleep because I was so nervous about competing. Well, I got on the computer, just sort of surfing the web and stuff, but I couldn't concentrate on anything. I was just sitting there, so I Googled myself. I never should have done that, Bree. The first was all the usual stuff you find when you Google yourself. Then I found a link to a Wikipedia page about me. I thought our club made it, or my dad or something, and there wasn't much there, just some basic facts about skating, what city I lived in. But the thing that got me was that it said I won that year's Crystal Classic. I mean, I laughed. I thought for sure someone just did it to encourage me. I confronted my dad about it, but he denied it. When I won the competition the next day, I was so happy. That was the first competition I had ever won, and it felt so good. I mean, remember how hard I worked after that? That's when my parents hired Sergey to coach me. You know how much that must have cost. After that, I would check my page before every competition, and it would always tell me the result of how I placed. It said I would win the regionals at 15, and all it came true. After that, Sergey convinced my mom and dad that I had a real shot at the Olympics. That's when they pulled me from school. I skated every day, but I just wasn't progressing the way Sergey said I needed to if I wanted a shot at the championship. I was working so hard and I was skating well, but still, Sergey said it wasn't good enough. When the sectionals came, all I could think about was winning, so I did something I shouldn't have. Everyone was saying that you were the favorite, and I felt like I had already lost the competition, so I made a Wikipedia account and tried to update my page that said I was the winner. The thing is, after I tried to update the page, I checked it, and all it said was, Honora Petrova is a selfish little bitch who is going to get what she deserves.
Whoa.
I broke down. That's why I looked so awful the next day. I was in a daze. I remember watching your routine and seeing your blade snap, and the next thing I know, I was on the ground, my face covered in blood from where the tip flew off and sliced my forehead. Then they told me it was my fault because I had your skates in my possession earlier. Bree, honestly, I didn't do anything to your skates. I wanted to win, but I wouldn't do anything to hurt you. When they told me I was banned from any further competitions, everyone said that I got what I deserved. Nobody even asked for my side of the story. I guess you heard that Sergey dropped me after that. He said I ruined him. No one would talk to me. Do you know what it's like to be ostracized by everyone? I couldn't even get ice time. And then the page got worse. Anytime I checked it, it would say all these horrible things about me. I can't even tell you half of them. The language was so vile. I'd cry every time I read it, but I couldn't stop checking it. I knew I had to do something, so I made a complaint to Wikipedia. I even tried calling them, but no one there claimed to know anything about the page. I was home alone that Friday night, and I decided to check to see if it had been taken down. The page was still there, only this time it said, Honora Petrova is a pathetic little orphan. I freaked. I kept calling my parents to warn them, but every time I call, all I would hear was this horrible laughter on the other end. I must have called them 100 times until I couldn't take the sound of the laughing anymore. After the accident, the police gave me their phones, and there wasn't any record of my calls that night. I was so devastated. Before that, I was... Hold on, what's happening?
What?
Oh, I heard something. Anyway. Before that, I was so busy training all day and doing homeschool, I never realized just how alone I had been the whole time. I know you tried to reach out, but I was so depressed and angry, I just shut everything out. Once I turned 18 and got the settlement money from the court, I came to Switzerland. I got to reinvent myself. My skating really took off. It hasn't been a year, and I feel like everything that has happened was so long ago. That's why I shouldn't have done it, Bree. I'm writing you now from an old hotel outside of Prague. I'm auditioning for the ice circus tomorrow. I know it's the kind of thing we used to make fun of, but I really want this. I was feeling really nervous and out of an old habit. I checked my page. It's so hard to say this, but when I checked the page to see if I'd get the job tomorrow, all it said is, Honora Petrova died friendless and alone. And it has today's date listed as the date of my death. I'm sobbing so hard I can barely type this, but I wanted you to know the truth. Please believe me, Bree. I attached a screenshot of the page so you'll believe me. It's all there, just as I told you. I don't know what to do. I don't know anyone here, and nobody speaks English. I keep refreshing the page. God, it's been forever. I keep refreshing, but it still hasn't changed. I'm waiting for midnight. I don't know what to do, so I locked myself in my room. There's only a few minutes to midnight now. All I can do is refresh the page. I'm exhausted, but I can't stop. I'm afraid to leave the computer until I know what happens next.
Ooh.
Dun, dun, dun.
That's messed
up,
man.
So that's some creepy boss there. Yeah, I thought so.
What about the... Have you been to the Wikipedia page?
Well, on that website is the picture of the Wikipedia page. We should probably Google Honora Petrova and see what happens.
I mean, the screenshot that they have there is pretty creepy as it is. There's like a really scary picture of this lady, and then it says all this stuff like, is a greedy little pig and will die alone. And it says all that stuff in the screenshot, but I don't know.
Right, but I don't know if it does in the actual Wikipedia page.
Oh, that's so crazy.
Cool.
Forget
it. So that's fake scary. I think it's time to move on to some real scariness, yeah?
Yeah, let's bring our this week's guest onto the show.
So, ladies and gentlemen, from a real live paranormal investigator, Colleen May is on the show. Colleen May, thank you. Colleen May, thank you for joining us.
Yes. Thank you for having me.
And it's pronounced Colleen, yes?
It is pronounced Colleen.
Yeah, the cool way to say that name.
Ha.
So
you
thanks
got,
for coming on the show.
You have fangs on? What are you? You're
no,
just
these
a.
These are my
got...
real teeth, but it's a good thing.
Oh, nice.
So, yes, Colleen is Don Juan DeMarco, I believe.
Yeah, Guy Fawkes.
Oh, Guy Fawkes!
Oh, nice. There you have it. Nice.
Speaking of Anonymous, that's awesome.
Guy Fawkes.
Ah, nice. There it is.
Nice mask.
Remember.
Remember. That's all.
The 5th of September? I don't know. Anyway, so we were lucky enough to get Colleen on the show because she knows Rob from a movie that they worked on together called Aces and Eights.
You were the
makeup artist for that movie?
Yes, sir. I do special effect makeup.
Awesome. So that's the other fun thing that you do. Besides the paranormal investigation, you're a professional makeup artist and costumer. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Did you have any events this weekend, or what for Halloween stuff?
I did, actually. I just came off of a 3-week run of Broadway Across America's presentation of Wicked.
Ooh. Oh,
wonderful show.
It was wicked.
So what was your job on the show?
I was a dresser for the principal males.
Oh, all the boys.
Yes, I had my hands full of some boys. I had my girl, Bach, and the wizard.
Oh, that's awesome.
So cool.
They have some really cool costumes, right? The goat and the,
they
I mean, the
do.
Wizard costumes.
Oh, those costumes, they're amazing.
Oh, man, that's awesome. So tell us a little bit about your Gorilla FX company and what you do.
Colleen May Gorilla FX. We do airbrush effects. We do special effects makeup. We've worked on a lot of films. We have a great crew. We've been around for a few years and having a blast.
That's nice. Awesome. If folks want to check out like what you do, or if they want to hire you, where do they go? I know you have a Facebook page.
I do have a Facebook page. It's Colleen May Gorilla FX, FX. And Gorilla is G-U-E-R-R-I-L-L-A. Or you can go to my website, which is colleenmay.com, C-O-L-L-E-E-N-M-A-Y.com.
Okay, cool. And we'll have all that stuff on the on our page with the podcast and stuff. So, folks, if you're listening to this, you can check all that out. If you're listening to it live, go check it out now.
Yeah, really cool pictures.
Go like the page. Yeah, there's lots of really cool pictures. And... yeah, and she can be the person for your next production.
Halloween.
What'd you do that stuff like sort of fun Halloween independent
makeup? Yeah.
Makeup.
Halloween is my busiest time of the year. We're so busy, we don't know which end is up.
Oh man. Well, I really appreciate you coming on the show.
Yeah.
When Rob told me that you were a paranormal investigator, I was like, get her on the show now.
Now, please.
So the name of your group is Show Me Ghosts West, right?
That is correct.
So tell us more about that. First of all, like the name and the group. You're centered out of Kansas City, Missouri, yeah?
That's correct, yes.
Missouri? I don't know.
Missouri, well, it depends on who you are and how you want to say it.
How do you say it?
I say Missouri.
Oh, okay. All right.
Normal.
I'll say Missouri just to get it crazy.
That's fine with me.
So how did you all get together?
Yeah.
Well, it's me and my sister and my brother-in-law, and we've been doing this together for most of our lives. And several years ago, we decided to hook it up with a bunch of equipment and go and check it out in real time.
So growing up, you and your sister would experience ghosts and...
Oh, yes. I've had my hands full of ghosts since I was a little kid.
Holy cow.
Really? Was your house haunted, or was it like the two of you would dare each other to go into like the haunted house in the neighborhood, or how did your like relationship with ghosts start so
early?
They've
got the sixth sense.
Yeah. Well, did you see dead people?
We grew up in a haunted house, and then just, you know, wherever we go, we have a tendency to find them, or they find us. So
wow,
that's kind of how we got
started. They reach out to you.
They totally do.
That is amazing. And so what kind of equipment and stuff do you use?
We have EMF detectors, which is electromagnetic frequency. We have digital voice recorders. We have infrared. No, we don't have any infrared. I wish we had infrared. We have, yes, we do. We have infrared. We don't have thermal cameras.
Mm. Okay. So, folks, if you're listening, go donate money so they can get a thermal camera. So
yes, please.
Need a thermal camera.
Yes. And so I love you have a lot of the investigations and stuff on your YouTube channel that people
yes.
can check out. On the Facebook page, there's a really – it scared the hell out of me. This electronic voice recording? What?
Yes,
was it EVP?
It's called an EVP. It's called an EVP, which is short for electronic voice phenomenon.
Oh, God. And you can hear – it's. I think it's you, yes? You're talking to –
It's either me or my sister. My sister is really, really good at those.
Oh, yeah? Okay. And you can hear like almost like a back and forth between her
yes.
and something. It's really cool.
Somebody.
Yeah. Yeah, and the cool thing is that, you know, most like most of the TV shows and everything that's mainstream about this is kind of produced, right? It's all kind of
yes.
set up, whereas Show Me Ghost
yes,
West,
ours are not
this
produced.
Is all authentic stuff.
Yeah,
people.
Is that true? Yes. Most production teams that you see investigating on TV set the things
yes.
up that happen?
Oh, yes. Well, you know, I'm not there, so I can't tell you, but I've worked in film long enough to know the difference between something that's produced and something that's raw.
Right.
Oh,
right.
Man.
Yeah.
She's calling them out.
You bet I am.
What's up, Ghost Hunters International? You ain't got nothing.
that's all fake.
So,
yeah, well...
Now we know. So I got to ask, what were some of the scariest things that happened to you when you were little that sort of spurred you on to be like, this is real, and we got to keep doing this?
Right, like you weren't scared at
waking
all?
Waking up in the middle of I wouldn't say that. It took me years to get over being scared.
Wow. Oh, God, I'm scared right now.
I know.
I woke up in the middle of the night and had individuals hanging over me that you could see through. Coming down the hallway, banging on the walls, closing doors, turning lights off, turning appliances on and off, throwing things off the refrigerator. I've had a little bit of all of those experiences. Somebody whispering in my ear. Just a little bit of everything.
These apparitions that would peer over you, was it sort of like, oh, I've identified you, there's a man and a little girl or whatever. Was it the same people or was it like different...
No, different people. I mean, they kind of went in cycles. I would have these individuals cycle through. It just depended on where I was and what I was doing, and sometimes they'd just come and hang out in my house, too.
Oh, jeez.
She's so nonchalant. Like, whatever, we'd hang out.
Watching the game.
Either deal with it or you go nuts, one or the other.
Oh, that is amazing. Gosh, I don't know. What are some of your sort of favorite investigative spots that you've done, like some of the fun stories that happened? Don't leave out any gruesome detail.
I think some of my favorite investigations have been done in Butler, Missouri, which is kind of an old Civil War area.
Okay.
It taught me an awful lot about the Civil War history just because we've dealt with so many ghosts down there.
Wow.
One of my favorites had to do, and we have video and audio up of this on our website and on our YouTube channel, was an old jail / schoolhouse that's down in Butler, Missouri, where they had an individual they brought in. It was a black man down around the turn of the century, and he hung himself in the jail cell. And so the first time we were there doing an investigation, we caught an EVP down in that jail cell of this individual asking us to get out. And then the next time we Yikes. Went down there, he had an EVP. He left us an EVP that said, help me out. So, you know, it's very sad to me because I believe that these guys are here for a reason, and it's very, very sad and frightening for them more than it is for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's that was the other question I really wanted to ask you is, you know, there's a lot of sort of different theories about, you know, what ghosts are. Are they simply sort of a like kind of a broken like recording or like a on the loop of something that happened in the past, or are they actual sort of spirits stuck between here and the other dimension? I mean, what do you think ghosts are? Are there more than one type?
You know, we've had experiences with both of those things that you mentioned. One of them we call a residual haunting, and it has to do with like a battle or a traumatic type of an incident that was so passionate and so emotional that those things hung in the air and they're on an anniversary type schedule. So they'll reoccur, but that doesn't necessarily mean that there is a personality to go with it. It's more like a residual energy. Mm-hmm. And then we have the ghosts, and the ghosts are individuals who just, for whatever reason, chose not to go on. And those reasons are as unique an individual as the individuals themselves.
Right, absolutely.
We've had ghosts who were traumatized so badly, you know, they were murdered or they died very suddenly, and they didn't know they were dead. Wow. We've had ghosts that didn't want to go on, and so they refused to go away. That was their house. We've had ghosts who believed that there was a heaven and a hell, and they were so rotten during their life that they were afraid they were going to hell when they died, so they didn't go anywhere.
Oh, wow. So that's what's going to happen to Chuck and I.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure I'm going to hell, so let's just hang out here.
Can I just stay on the couch while you guys live here? So when you say that you have, like, EVP recordings and stuff, does that make you... your sister, your brother-in-law, are you guys like seance mediums too, or like?
I've been a seance medium most of my life, although I don't typically do that a lot anymore, except on our investigations.
Okay. So yeah, you primarily do the investigations. You're not going around and trying to contact people for other folks out there and stuff.
Not as but a you, rule.
But you use those methods in order to talk to
communicate with the ghosts.
Communicate. Yeah. Wow, so you guys you've had that kind of power like all your life, huh? You and your sister.
I wouldn't call it a power, but
yeah. Well, I mean, the ability to.
Yeah,
write,
the ability to speak with the dead. Yes, I have done this all of my life.
Wow. What about your brother-in-law? Like when he came into this family, was he like, you know, I've had the same experiences.
Yes, like, actually, my brother-in-law is Choctaw Indian, so we were able to put our systems together and work very well that way.
That's really cool.
What are some of the things that he brings from his background into it?
You know, he has such a unique perspective, such an earthy perspective, mm-hmm. and it's different because, like, we've had to deal with some Native American spirits before, and so Bobby knows how to talk to them.
Wow.
You know, he knows what kind of superstitions they might respond to. He knows what kind of religious beliefs they might respond to. That's what we're looking to do, is get them to respond to us.
Okay. Yeah, so that's the other sort of burning question is what do you see as your sort of ultimate goal as paranormal investigators? Because I know groups like TAPS or, you know, there's a bunch of groups even here in Michigan where I am, and really for them it's just sort of about finding evidence. But do you feel like you have an obligation to not, you know, to do more than that, to really help those spirits who are sort of stuck? Or
we believe that, and it's something, you know, this is one of our slogans: ghosts are not pets, they're human beings.
That's beautiful.
Isn't that nice? That's nice. My lovely sister.
That's awesome.
Nice.
So yeah, our ultimate goal is to help them. I mean, to help cross over. You can't go on with your lessons if you're stuck somewhere.
Yeah.
So, and we've discovered too that the more they're on an earth plane, the more forgetful and angry and jealous and frustrated they become.
Sure.
So it's hard to talk with them.
Are there any stories you have where you, and any kind of confirmation that you were successful in doing so?
Absolutely. You know, a very dear friend of ours passed away a few years ago, and my son moved into his house shortly after he passed away. And he started having incidents where the dog would go crazy, and people were starting to see our friend and hear him. And so they had us come in for an investigation one night. As a matter of fact, you'll find that in our videos. That's in the okay. big, long You're Not Crazy. He was able to confirm for us. He talked with us, and he made noises for us, and then we were able to help him to go on.
Oh, wow. So that he wasn't present anymore. And
Right, yes.
Wow. So cool.
I know, right? So for sort of the young paranormal investigators up and coming, what advice would you give to them as they're, you know, if folks want to go out and sort of try to do this as well, in the hopes that they would do sort of the same thing that you're doing, you know, one, raising awareness about it, but two, trying to like sort of help those
right.
spirits to cross over?
Yeah, first things first, it's not fun and games. It can be very dangerous, and we have brought spirits home before.
Oh,
and
that, man.
What?
That can be a handful for sure.
Oh.
So you need to know how to protect yourself and what you're getting into. It's not a joke. It's not fun. It's not games, and people can get hurt.
Wow. And has anybody ever been sort of physically hurt on your team?
We had, it wasn't on our team, but it was a That's property good. Owner who called us in. We also have that as on our, we have all of the video from that particular, that's Granny's Attic. And the lady who owned the place who had us come in, she got scratched, and at the same time she got scratched, and she's remarking that her back hurts, and she has three big old long scratch marks down her back. We picked
what?
Up a DVD from an old woman who was telling her to get off my bed.
Oh my God!
Yeah, truth. You guys can see all of that. It's in an hour and a half long special, and that one's Granny's Attic.
Granny's Attic scares the piss out of me.
Yeah, that was a very
sorry.
Place.
Oh, wow.
Jeez.
So what are some ways that you try to protect yourself?
Yeah, like how do you prevent some, you know,
right,
a spirit
like,
or a ghost coming home with you, or, you know, jumping in the backseat of your car or whatever.
Right, like, yo!
I tell them they can't. It's like having a human being around you with no body. You purely tell them you can't come with me and you have to mind your manners.
Okay, I see.
Yeah, does that always work, though? I mean, Rob barely minds his manners, and I can
yeah,
see
we're like,
he's not.
No, it doesn't always work, and that's when you have to call in the heavy guns. But by and large, yes, they need to listen to you when you tell them to mind their manners.
Okay. What are the heavy guns?
The heavy guns. Well, yeah, we call in the Ghostbusters. We have our own little proton packs, you know. No, the heavy guns really is more like along a spiritual avenue. We call
okay.
in, we do a lot of prayer work, we do a lot of Native American ceremonial type stuff and try to help that, you know, take away the negativity.
That is awesome. So what plans do you have for the busy week of the year? Are you doing any investigations during Halloween?
And no investigations this week. We're too busy with makeup.
Yeah.
Oh, right. We're turning real people into ghosts.
Yes.
The safe way. Did you notice that there's an increase around Halloween of activity and stuff, or?
You know, I worked for several years as a makeup artist in some of the biggest haunted houses, commercial haunted houses in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
And we noticed that during and they were very, very haunted, really, outside of being commercial scares.
Oh, man.
But we noticed that the week leading up to Halloween was very, very active. And then after Halloween, it died down again until the next year. So, yeah, there are certain times of the year, especially when the energy builds around it, that they become more active.
Oh, okay. I thought it was just Mercury in retrograde.
So what are some other factors that can cause a site to be active. I mean, obviously something like the Civil War, where all these people died in horrible experiences, yes, is one. But what are some, yeah, other things that you noticed?
Usually it has to do, and this can be as unique as the individuals, but usually it has to do with somebody who purely doesn't know they're dead or they don't want to go on.
We've had some
experiences with situations where people got into some ritual magic or some Ouija boards and they didn't know what they were doing, and it caused them some spiritual issues.
Oh, God. Wow. So Ouija boards aren't just Milton Bradley. It's for real.
No,
Parker Ouija Brothers.
They're very dangerous, and I highly recommend you stay away from them. I don't touch them.
Oh, God, I'm so scared. Yeah,
no, I have a couple, like, you know, kind of creepy stories. Rob, I think, was around for one of our horrible Ouija events, yes? Rob, do you remember this?
What do you mean?
Yes, I remember sitting around the table Ouija boarding.
Yeah, well, stupid idea. And we're hanging out, and I don't remember how it happened, but all of a sudden the planchard, I don't know, planchard, the thing that moves, got real sort of heavy, and it spelled something like "get out."
Was moving it.
I was moving.
And it was Rob, my sister, and I at my parents' house, and we were so freaked out that we got in Rob's truck
and got out.
We drove to Taco Bell and ate a bunch of burritos.
We hit the border.
Had some hauntings over Ouija boards. Basically, you're opening up a portal for anything to come through, and the bad guys have a whole lot less to be doing with their time than the good guys.
Oh, man.
So even if I'm just trying to find out if this girl has a crush on me, I could be opening up a portal for Zool to come through and just take us all out?
Well, I don't know about Zool. I think he's kind of a busy guy, but yes, you've got the idea.
I didn't know that. I mean, it's all just, I thought it was just like, you know, we were all just like, this little fortune-telling little thing, but we've been just letting in spirits.
Well, welcome to the world of marketing, you know? They've done a great, great job marketing that as a game.
Yeah, yeah. Ay. Well, I want to thank you for coming into our portal this week.
Sure.
and enlightening us. Is there anything before you go that you you want to tell us? God, I could keep you on here forever, but we don't
you
have
guys
forever.
Can have me back any old time. I'd be happy to come back. Okay. You know, happy Halloween. That's my
happy Halloween. Right,
that's it. Yeah.
So if folks want to check out your stuff, where do they go?
You can go several different places. We have Show Me Ghosts, and ghosts is plural. We have showmeghostswest.com. You can find us at Show Me Ghosts West on YouTube, and you can find us at Show Me Ghosts West on Facebook.
Is there a Show Me Ghosts East?
I don't know. We haven't found them if they are.
Oh, okay. Maybe I could start Show Me Ghosts Midwest.
There you go.
That would be awesome. Okay, cool. So we'll have all that stuff on our page, and people can check it out. I know I'm probably going to spend the rest of the night freaking myself watching someone scratch somebody else's back on camera.
Yeah, well, don't watch that stuff in the dark by yourself, guys. It really will creep you out.
I can't handle it. All right. Well, thanks again. Wow. And folks, remember Colleen May Gorilla FX as well. For the safer way to spook your friends,
yes.
She's got some amazing works that she does. Thank you again for Colleen.
Thank you, Colleen.
Show.
So much.
Thank you, guys. Have a great Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Thanks.
Wow, that was nuts.
Colleen May, paranormal investigator.
Yeah, we're gonna put all her
guests so far. Don't tell any of our other guests.
So go to our Facebook page. We're gonna put all her information up on there. You gotta check this stuff out, guys. It's really, really cool. On that note, you should like us on Facebook, facebook.com/WestXMidwest. You can follow and tweet us on Twitter, @West_X_Midwest is our handle. You can email us at WestXMidwestPodcast@gmail.com or watch our show on YouTube. This recording will be on there. Just search WestXMidwest on YouTube. But yeah, subscribe, stream, download, write a review if you have time on iTunes.
Write a review if you don't have time. Just write a review. You're like, these guys are sweet. Takes three seconds.
Put all your candy down and write a review for us.
Stop beating your face. There's going to be razor blades in your Snickers anyway.
And after your trick-or-treating, while you're trick-or-treating with all the other your friends, tell them about the show, okay?
That's right. So, Rob, Chuck, happy Halloween. Be safe,
happy
my friends.
Happy Halloween to you, huh?
And
happy
I will.
Happy Halloween.
Check your candy.
Check your candy, friends. Happy Halloween to all of our guests, and we will see y'all next week.
Yeah, I'm Chuck Anchori.
I'm Aral Gribble. On behalf of Rob Hubbard, this is Ben.
West!
By me? Wait. That's my spooky sign off.
See you next week.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood. And whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell. Stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller. Ha 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 ha